Welcome to this first video in this series on StorSimple 8000 Migration to Azure File Shares and Azure File Sync. My name is Terry Clancy. In this video, I will provide an overview of Azure File Shares and Azure File Sync and will describe at a high level the recommended approach to migration from StorSimple 8000. In later videos, we will talk in more detail about each of the phases of the recommended migration process. With StorSimple approaching its end of life in December 2022, we recommend that you start planning the migration of your data off your StorSimple appliances as soon as possible. Good planning is essential to ensure a successful migration. While there are many Microsoft and third-party storage solutions available that offer similar functionality as StorSimple, Azure File Shares, used in conjunction with Azure File Sync, or AFS, for local caching, provides the ideal migration path for your StorSimple workloads. Let's start by looking at a high level how Azure File Shares compares and adds value to StorSimple. In Azure, we have two different types of storage. We have object storage implemented as Azure Blob Storage, and we have file storage supported by Azure Files and Azure File Sync. Blob storage is what you're currently using with your StorSimple deployment. When you go into a storage account used by StorSimple and look at the data, you see a flat namespace. You do not see a hierarchy of files and folders. Rather, what you see is a bunch of objects with GUIDs. Blob storage is optimized for storing massive amounts of unstructured data and is meant for applications like StorSimple to use and is not meant for users to interact with. StorSimple blob storage can only be accessed through a StorSimple device, and to use SMB shares, you need to iSCSI attach a Windows server for users to connect to. The other type of storage is what Azure File Shares provides. Azure Files is a fully managed file share service built on file storage with a native hierarchy of files and folders. Azure File Shares provide native SMB or server message block file shares in the cloud with no VM or virtual machine required. You can just go to Azure and provision a storage account to create Azure SMB file shares. Users can then directly connect to those file shares. For on-prem caching like StorSimple, Azure File Shares can be used with Azure File Sync, which provides on-prem SMB shares to both simplify and speed up access. Before we discuss migration planning, let's look at Azure File Shares in more detail. Azure File Shares are considered by most StorSimple customers as the best migration option because they offer fully managed file shares in the cloud. This means they operate without the need for virtual machines and are accessible via the industry standard server message block or SMB protocol. With shares that can be mounted concurrently by cloud or on-premises deployments of Windows, Linux, and Mac OS, connected directly using the InternetSafe SMB 3.0 protocol over port 445. Or the same clients can connect over a VPN like ExpressRoute, or you can use Azure File Sync or AFS to cache the hot files from an Azure File Share on-premises, and your local users and apps can then access that local server with local access performance. Or you can connect to Azure File Shares over NFS 4.1. So, a key benefit of Azure File Shares is that they expose industry-standard SMB file shares in the cloud, and you can leave the closed ecosystem of StorSimple behind. The key difference compared to StorSimple is that you can connect to Azure File Shares directly from other resources in the cloud because you are no longer dependent on going through the StorSimple device. Let's now focus on Azure File Sync, which you can optionally use with Azure File Shares. The Azure File Sync agent runs as a background service on Windows servers and provides on-premises tiered file caching for fast access near where the data is being used. Azure File Sync supports multi-site sync, whereas StorSimple only allowed a single device per cloud store. This is ideal if you have multiple locations all needing fast access to the same data or applications. Like StorSimple, Azure File Sync also provides cloud tiering, with all files always being kept in the cloud, whereas locally it keeps a full namespace so that to users, all the files appear to exist in their folders, while maintaining a heat map based on when files were last used, so that it then only keeps complete file data locally for a relatively small subset of recently used or hot files, and retrieving all other older or cold files from the cloud upon request. Azure File Sync policies provide more control over tiering than was previously provided by StorSimple and provides greater visibility of metrics like cache hit ratio, allowing for more granular and informed management. Another key feature is cloud backups. When using Azure File Sync, all your data is held in the cloud, with the hottest data also cached locally. So it is easy to accomplish a full backup in the cloud, and so on-premises backups are no longer required. With StorSimple, data was backed up using volume clones. With Azure File Sync, you take more granular Azure File Share snapshots. These are very clever delta snapshots, so only the delta between the two snapshots will increase storage consumption in the cloud. The cool thing about them is that you can mount a snapshot to provide direct access to a read-only view of that snapshot as an SMB share to provide greater flexibility. This sort of easy access to backups is changing the game. You could not do that with your StorSimple storage, with the exception that the 8000 series does support mounting volume backups, but not at the share level. You can take snapshots or backups manually, or you can have Azure Backup optionally orchestrate backups and retention schedules, as well as giving powerful restore capabilities to original location, alternative location, with single file restore, or with whole of share restore options. If you lose an on-prem server, your files are backed up in the cloud. So, if disaster strikes, you can simply bring up a new server, install Azure File Sync agent on the new server, and then connect it to whatever file shares you want. And then you can get your files back using a process we call RapidDR. At first, your entire namespace comes down. This is just the metadata, so this makes your server accessible and usable very quickly because the users can see all the files. And then, as users access files, they will be recalled and cached locally as required. You can also define policies that drive recall based, for example, on last modified timestamp, etc. As you can see, Azure File Shares used with Azure File Sync offers several benefits when compared to StorSimple. Azure File Shares can be accessed either directly from other cloud software or directly from on-premises or through Azure File Sync. Files can be accessed over SMB, REST, or NFS protocols. Share-level snapshots can be mounted as SMB shares. Azure File Sync supports multi-site sync so that dozens of Windows servers in different locations can provide cached access to the same share. StorSimple only supports one device per store. Azure File Sync also offers a richer and growing set of metrics and policies to monitor, control, and optimize caching behavior. Now let's talk about the migration process. The Azure Files team recently released an update to the StorSimple Data Manager, so it now supports migration of data from StorSimple to Azure File Shares and Azure File Sync. The main objective of this update is to migrate data off StorSimple appliances while minimizing downtime and impact to users. To achieve these objectives, a cloud-side migration is used to avoid recalling all the data to on-prem, which avoids unnecessary delays and network congestion and avoids the jumbling of the StorSimple cache, which would result in a bad user experience during the migration. Note that StorSimple Data Manager-based migrations only work with StorSimple 8000 series devices. So, if you have 5000 or 7000 series devices, you first need to migrate your data to an 8000 series device before migrating your data to Azure File Shares. Microsoft can lend you a StorSimple 8000 series device for 6 months to aid in your migration to Azure File Shares. If you are using a StorSimple 1200 virtual array device, you will be following a different migration path, and a link to the documentation on that path can be found at the end of this video. Let's take a look at the migration process using StorSimple Data Manager and 8000 series devices. To get started, you first take a fresh backup of your StorSimple volume. The most recent backup will be the source of the copy. During the copy, users can continue to work on the live data stored on your StorSimple devices, and we will copy across any changes that occur later. Next, you create an instance of the StorSimple Data Manager resource in Azure. This tool has been updated to support migrations from StorSimple to Azure File Shares. Then you create your target Azure File Shares. Next, you create a number of StorSimple Data Manager jobs using StorSimple Data Manager. Each job can take all or part of the content from a StorSimple volume into the root or other folder in an Azure Share. So you can optionally specify to take only certain folders from the StorSimple volume into an Azure File Share. That allows you to create multiple jobs, each taking a set of folders from the same StorSimple volume, but migrating them into different Azure File Shares. In each job, you can select a subset of that volume's backups to be migrated. The selected data will be migrated from those backups, starting with the oldest backup first, proceeding in order, ending with the most recent backup. Between migration of each backup, an Azure File Share snapshot is taken to record the state of the share corresponding to that backup. Once your job is defined, you then kick off your first job and the data starts flowing as specified. Next, ensure you have provisioned an Azure File Sync or AFS server or VM on premises and that you have installed the latest Azure File Sync agent on it. Then when, and only when, you have confirmed that the StorSimple Data Manager jobs have completed, you can configure Azure File Sync sync groups for the Azure File Shares that have finished receiving data from StorSimple Data Manager. Namespace data will then start flowing and the job status will show initial sync until the namespace has finished syncing. After AFS has completed its initial sync, it's time to take users offline and perform a final robocopy to catch up on any changes the users have made while the migration was in process. And when that is complete, users can be reconnected to the new Azure File Sync shares. So once you are all set and done, we can start to decommission all the things that are not necessary. You do not need your StorSimple anymore, so if you are ready, that can be decommissioned. And you don't need Data Manager and its related resources either, so you can decommission those too. So with that, your migration is complete. Currently, we are seeing StorSimple Data Manager migrate around 1.1 million files, which in our test case was about 1 terabyte, in about 4 hours. Now we've covered the basics of migrating StorSimple data to Azure File Shares using StorSimple Data Manager. In the next videos, we will look at each of the stages in this process in more detail, starting with preparing and planning for your migration. Here are some resources you can leverage to help you plan your StorSimple migration and learn more about Azure File Shares. And here are some links for Azure File Sync and the StorSimple Data Manager migration tool. Microsoft Customer Service has previously sent out email notifications of the upcoming StorSimple retirement date to all StorSimple customers. However, please ensure that someone from your organization sends us an email to confirm the current and appropriate contacts at your company so we can follow up with them regarding your StorSimple data storage migration options. And please be sure to include your StorSimple device serial numbers. We will send you the customer assessment intake form to help us better assess your specific environment and help you to plan your migration approach. We'll also send you other reference materials to guide you through the migration process. We will also include information about our office hours where you can discuss your specific migration issues and ask questions with our migration team. If you do complete the migration process without our assistance, we ask that you please email us to let us know when you have completed your data migration. Please include your serial numbers, as mentioned earlier, so we can effectively track your migration status. Should you have any other questions we could answer, feel free to contact us at storsimp@microsoft.com. That is storsimp@microsoft.com. We hope this video provides you with the necessary information to begin your StorSimple migration. Thanks for listening, and we wish you all the best with your migration.